to watch videos, and when we were live, we have like already spent 2 to 3 hours watching videos instead of doing homework, and we just lose time there. YouTube is an open network that people use to share videos, and we also use it to learn more. We can find videos on some how to cook and how to solve a math problem, to how to dye your hair or something like that. And as part of this society, we always use YouTube instead of, sometimes in class, instead of putting attention or something, we're watching a video, funny video, a new video, a music video that is coming out, and we just lose too much time on YouTube that we don't realize the impact that it is creating on us. Now that you guys have an understanding on how YouTube influences, we want to see how can you use YouTube wisely. First, I'll talk about the problems, the causes, and the solutions. To begin with, all these problems. When we're watching any video on YouTube, there's always ads, and everything that we see that is coming out, we want it. If there's like a new product, we want it. If we see that a new phone is coming, new makeup or something, we always want everything new. And we don't realize that we sometimes just don't need the products, but we just want it. We depend so much on social media too. And sometimes there's the Wi-Fi is too slow, or we don't have Wi-Fi, we get like in a bad mood or something, because we have the feeling that we need to be connected to someone else, or we're watching something that is impacting us psychologically. According to InjustMeet, in the article US Data on November 2007, reveals that an average of teenagers from 15 to 18 and people from 20 to 34 are the group that are more attracted to advertisers from different companies, and companies use it to promote more of their products, and they are sure that they will sell more. Mary Sheriff on May 6, 2014, the article is YouTube good or bad influence on society proves that teenagers that spend more time using YouTube have a lower performance on school, and that impacts them not only professional but mentally too, because when they're not passing their classes or something, they get depressed and they just don't want to keep trying. Now that I talk about the problems, I'll talk about the solutions, the causes. One of the main causes is that we're so much influenced by people, by your family, by actors and everything, that we don't put attention to what we're actually doing. Advertising is one of the main factors. They usually use celebrities or someone like very normal so they can promote their products. And sometimes we develop an idea that we need to have the newest products in order to fit to the society. According to Erica Megan, March 9, the article Advertising Targets of Effects in Teens says that advertising is a pervasive influence on teens. And in 1 year, teens view more than 40,000 advertisements, ads on TV, magazines, or online. Also, the lack of confidence. As teenagers, sometimes we have a lack of confidence on how we look or something. And every product that we see, like as makeup or product hair or anything, we want it because we believe we'll be looking better or something. But in reality, it's just a part of that. It's just coming out, and nothing of that usually makes you look better. And according to Mary, on 2011, on May 11, 2008, the article Advertising and Its Effects said that teenagers are often target of advertising because they grow up a habit of having the newest item that are coming out like iPhones or makeup, because if they see like their friend or someone else that they have the new products, they want to fit in and feel better. Now that I have talked about the causes, I'll talk about the solutions. Personally, I'll say be yourself. You don't need the new products in order to fit in. If someone's like you the way you are, you don't need to have the new products or everything they have. Also, as a society, we have to put more attention to what we are buying and consuming, not only like as like products like hair products or makeup and like technology products, but also food. Now to wrap things up, now that I have talked about the problems, the causes, and the solutions. Now that you guys have an understanding how the impact of YouTube is creating on that, in fact, we'll be more careful on how to use it. First, I talk about the problems, the causes, and the solutions, and going back to the story, we can keep looking at videos on maybe how to do our makeup or hair and everything, but we have to keep in mind that buying the new products or everything is not gonna sometimes make us feel better, because we all are unique in our own way, and we don't need the new products or to feel better or fitting in a society that we're never gonna please.